The formula for percent is percent equals a number of parts divided by the total number of parts. And there are three components of a percent problem: the base, the rate, and the part. The base is the whole or total number of parts. The rate is a percent, a number followed by the percent sign, and the part is a part of the base, a part of the total number of parts. So the formula would be rate, R, equals part, P, divided by the base, B. For example, let's say that you have 20 t-shirts to sell, and you sell 11 of them. What is the percent of t-shirts sold? The base would be the whole, or total number of parts, which is 20 t-shirts. The part would be part of the base. In this case, the 11 t-shirts you sold, out of the total number of t-shirts, 20. And the rate would be the percentage of t-shirts sold. Using our formula, we have rate equals part divided by base. So we have rate equals 11 t-shirts sold over 20 total t-shirts. Using a calculator, 11 divided by 20 equals 0.55. To convert a decimal to a percent, we just move the decimal two places to the right, attach a percent sign, and we have 55% as a final answer. And this formula, with the three components, can be modified to also solve for base or part. To solve for part, we can multiply both sides by base, which will cancel this base out and leave us with base times rate equals part. And we can make this look a little cleaner. So part equals rate times base. For example, let's say that you give a friend 25 t-shirts to sell, and a week later they tell you they sold 80% of them. How many t-shirts did they sell? So here we know the rate is 80% and the base is 25. 25 total t-shirts. So we need to solve for part. Part equals rate times base. The rate would be 80%, and the base is the 25 total t-shirts you gave them. To convert percent to a decimal, we would drop the percent sign and move the decimal point two places to the left to get 0.8. Now using a calculator, we have 0.8 times 25, and our final answer is 20, which is the part. So they sold 20 t-shirts. To solve for base, we can modify our original formula of rate equals part over base. We multiply both sides by base to get base times rate equals part. And now we divide both sides by rate, which will cancel the rate out on the left side, and we have base equals part over rate. As an example, let's say that you gave another friend a box of t-shirts to sell, and a week later they brag to you about their sales skills. They say they've sold 45 t-shirts, 90% of the t-shirts in the box you gave them. How many total t-shirts was in the box? Here, we know the rate is 90%, and we know the part is 45. 45 out of the total. So we need to solve for the base, the total amount. Base equals part over rate. So we have 45 divided by 90%. To convert percent to a decimal, we would drop the percent sign and move the decimal point two places to the left to get 0.9. Now, using a calculator, we have 45 divided by 0.9. And our final answer is 50, which is the base, the total number of t-shirts in the box we gave them to sell. And in the next few videos, I'll go over more examples of solving for rate, solving for base, and solving for part. All right, my friends, hopefully you got something out of this video. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here.